people. Okay, so aisa bhi na ho sakta. You can have a UPT or a Haryana tea, you know, which is Uttarakhand tea. Not, we're not talking about production. No, no Uttarakhand tea. We have to have a tea, the way of, we have to have a tea, the one that is consumed at that place. You can have a Gujarati tea, because Gujarat doesn't have tea, but still they make their own masala tea. Okay, so you can have your names. Next is Earl Grey. This is a tough one. This is different. What is Earl Grey? No.
It's a part of wood, some kind of wood.
No, not really. See, essentially Earl Grey is a flavored tea. It uses black tea as a base, and then there's this particular fruit, bergamot. The extract of the bergamot is used in scenting the tea. So if you have any scent, if you have any special perfume which is edible and goes well with tea, the tea can get that name, whether it's rose, jasmine, or whatever.
So
It's called, it's spelled like B, B like Bombay, England, R, Bur, G A, Germany, Agra, and M O T. If you search on the net, you will get that name easy. And it's a fruit usually found in the Mediterranean countries. The extract from this fruit has a very interesting sour and a pronounced flavor. Okay? Then we have jasmine tea, same thing. Tea which has been flavored with jasmine flowers. Remember that jasmine flowers, if you dry them, they will never have the flavor of the fresh flowers. So while the flowers are still fresh,
blooming,
it is, you know, we are blooming, or at a certain stage, they'll come in contact with the tea. The tea leaves will just absorb the aroma that emanates from the flowers, and it will become a jasmine tea. So this is again a flavored tea. Lychee tea, flavored tea, China tea. China tea and English tea are two different concepts, because English tea is defined by the consumers, and China tea is defined by the growers. So it's China tea because it is grown in China. It could be black, green. Like China tea probably is, and India tea is probably the two widest terms. You can have 100 varieties in both the categories, right? But still, since somebody said China tea, we have to explain, you know, what it means.
So doesn't jasmine tea come under the Chinese tea?
Yes, it would. But then China tea, anything that is grown, anything that's produced in China is a China tea. So if a guest asks you, I want to drink China tea, what do you tell him? I have 10 different types of Chinese tea. No, you give him the most popular Chinese tea, which is either a green tea or a jasmine tea. Because he probably means that, but he's not able to convey it. You have to understand what the person is trying to say. Darjeeling tea, this is also interesting. Place of origin, it's a place where tea is grown. And Darjeeling is special, but we're not going to discuss because we have no time. I'll just wind up. And Assam tea, similarly, Assam. Darjeelings usually are light and flavorful. They are more complex. They are slightly difficult to brew to perfection. But Assam teas are usually strong and dark and easier to make. So if you have a choice of two teas to make for guests who are not so demanding, Assam is usually an easier choice, a better choice. And finally, I can't read wheat tea, sweet tea. Anyway, something with W-E-E-K. That person is not here. Maybe white tea. No, it doesn't look like white tea. Anyway, friends, I think. So green tea we already discussed in detail because it's a unoxidized tea and clearer tea. Okay, before I get pushed out of this room, I would like to wind up, and we still have our stall outside till tomorrow. And do we have a session tomorrow as well? Better be when we try to have.